In this video, we're talking about the angle addition postulate, what it is, and how to use it to solve some problems. So let's say that we have a large angle, and we draw a ray extending from the vertex. Well, this splits that larger angle into two smaller angles. Well, basically what the angle addition postulate says is that the measure of those two angles, whatever they are, always have to add up to equal, they must equal the measure of the third angle, the larger angle. And we can use this template here then to solve some problems involving the angle measurements. So for example, let's say that we know that the two smaller angles are 55 and 45 degrees. Well, to figure out what the angle is for that, or the measure of that larger angle is, all we have to do is add those two numbers together, and we'll figure out that the larger angle, the angle that includes both of those, is 100 degrees. So we just add the two smaller ones to equal the larger. And we can also, if we have to work in reverse, say we're trying to figure out what one of the smaller angles are, well, we just manipulate that equation a little bit by taking the total, the larger angle, in this case 100 degrees, and subtracting the smaller one that we know, and then whatever's left has to be the measure of that missing angle. Now, we can also use this template when we're dealing with algebra issues. Okay, so let's say that we have some angle measures given to us as this, maybe 5x and 4x plus 20, and maybe we know that the larger angle is 110. Well, again, if we start with this template equation, we know that those two smaller angles have to add up to equal the measure of the largest angle. So all we have to do is plug those into our template formula here that we've created. So we can just plug in the first angle of 5x, we can plug in the second angle of 4x plus 20, that's been what's given to us. We know that the largest angle is 110, so then those two expressions have to add up to equal 110. And now we have an equation that we can use and start solving using our skills. So as we know, combine the x's that are on the same side of the equation, any like terms that we can combine, let's combine. And by doing so, we've kind of simplified that equation to 9x plus 20 equals 110. And now we can start moving things to the other side of the equation, away from our x, by subtracting 20 first and then dividing by 9 to figure out that x is equal to 10. And if we needed to know what those angle measurements are, all we have to do is plug in that 10 into the 5x and the 4x plus 20 to figure out what those angle measures are. So that's the angle addition postulate in a nutshell. Stay tuned for the next video on angle bisectors.